Hi, now that the US elections are over, we can focus on important stuff. Like this guy unscrewing a light bulb, screwing it up his butt cheeks, putting his finger in the light socket, and then the light turns on when the lady switches the light through disguise, you guessed it, butt cheeks. I have the link to the video in the descriptions. Yes, the butt cheek guy did it, but how? You need a long roll of wire. In an adult, there is around 0.5 meter from mouth through stomach, another 6 meters through small intestine, and 1 meter through big intestine to the so a 10 meter wire should be long enough. Then you put some electric tape at the end of the wire to make it soft so it doesn't scratch your internals. Then you start guiding it in. Don't push it in, let it find its way. Pull some workable length of wire out of the other end. Now attach a light bulb socket at the end of the wire. Are you still following this? I was joking! Pull that wire out of your mouth! Well, hands down to this guy. His butt cheeks actually turned on the light. I can't call this fake though. He's like a magician. You don't call fake every time a magician does a trick. But something is for sure. He didn't pass electricity through his body. You need power, but you don't need AC. You can create 120 volt DC by connecting a bunch of 9 volt batteries in series. Let me measure the voltage across 13 9-volt batteries with my mushimeter. Yes, you heard me right, it's called mushimeter. Maybe I call it moshe to make it sound fancier. I discovered it all on my own. It is a high-precision, low-cost multimeter that uses your smartphone as the display and controls, can measure current and voltage at the same time, can plot them, and also data log. This is awesome. I'll give away 10 of these. Measuring the battery pack with Moshe, I see that the voltage across it is around 120 volts. And unlike AC, DC is much safer to the touch. I still feel it a little bit in my fingers, but it's nowhere close to the imminent death feeling you get from touching AC. And the current through my body is between 1 to 2 milliamps depending on how I touch it. Of course, this is DC, but something you may not know is that a lot of things you plug in at home don't care if it is AC or DC. For example, switch mode wall adapters. Like, here's my phone. Or my daughter's keyboard. Or the incandescent light. You see that the voltage drops to 110 volts under 0.4 amps of current. The crappy 60 watt lamp only uses 45 watts. Or LED lights. It draws only 0.1 amps and it's much brighter. LED lights, man. Start using them. Don't be a planet hater. Now we have our supply, we need a switch to turn it on and off. Back to our butt cheek hero, if I slow down the video, you see that the butt light turns on first and then the room light. So somebody in that room has a remote switch and didn't synchronize well. I found these products. This one is a remote switch that you can plug anything into and turn it on and off. The problem with this one, as I tried, is that it only works with AC. This one, on the other hand, is a light that has the power supply and the wireless circuit in the light, and you only need this remote to turn it on and off. The problem with this one is that they programmed it such that it dims on and off, so it doesn't quite match the PowerBot video. I guess I have to modify this one to work with DC. Looking at the circuit of this switch, it has a capacitor that blocks DC, so I just have to short this capacitor. So I just short across the capacitor. Now I just connect it to the battery and it's... It was a mistake. See, the capacitor wasn't there to block DC. It was stepping down the AC, feeding into a full bridge rectifier, where you get your DC output to power your circuit. I can bypass the capacitor with a resistor to step down the voltage. It would be very inefficient, as resistors waste a lot of power, unlike a capacitor, like 1 watt in this case. But it would be good enough for a trick. And voila! Now all you need is a pocket in your pants to hold all these, or strong butt muscles, or just shove them all up your
giveaway time!
So I found the Moshe meter on the web and decided to contact the company and ask for a sample to try. And did some research and realized that they are one of those awesome crowdfunded companies where engineers come up with a great idea, follow through with it, and make it into a great product. So thanks to Moshe for providing 10 multimeters to my patrons at patreon.com. And thank you for supporting my channel, all 96% men and 4% women viewers. I thought my unibrow was attractive. It's okay, you are beautiful on the inside.